but you travel on. There's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door, where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar, come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today.
You know, these trucks, that's all he's done. And I met this guy with the auto car with a double disc pump, and it gave him problems going up to Kirkland's, Plymouth. Him and Ellie riding in this goddamn auto car, and the pump goes out, they fix the double disc pump and this and that, and then the fender bracket broke on the way, so they had to take the strap. Leather strap, I don't know if it was his belt or off his luggage or something. Tie the front fender down. And so we were at the hotel and we run bump into him, you know, that's how I met Terry, and they came down to our room and I'm sure we went to their room for a drink.
Yeah.
That's I'm sure was in the deal. That was probably at Sutter Creek that time when we stayed at Sutter Creek. And ever since then, we've always met up somewhere along the way to go to this show or whatever it was. But this is for you, TK.
he's pounding down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound just like no bandit run. Keep your foot hard on the pedal, son, never mind them brakes. Let it all hang out, cause we got a run to make. The boys are thirsty in Atlanta, and there's beer in Texarkana, and we'll bring it back no matter what it takes. Eastbound and down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch your bandit run. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch your bandit run. Old Smokey's got them ears on, he's hot on your trail, and he ain't gonna rest till you're in jail. So you got to dodge him, you got to duck him, you gotta keep that diesel trucking. Just put that hammer down and give it hell. Eastbound and down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch your bandit run.
Hey Terry, good to see you. Well, good to talk to you. I can't see you, but you've been a pleasure to know. I just can't hardly believe it's been 20 years since I met you. I think it was in Kansas City. It might have been in Syracuse, but you're one hell of a guy. Always got the best of ATHS for you.
Yeah.
Even when we're sitting in a restaurant and you pull your pistol out instead of your wallet. That's been known to happen more than once. So once in a while, things happen. But it's always great to see you and Ellie.
Terry and I have gone, we go way back. Back before you were born. 1972. When were you born?
71.
Well, you were there then, I guess. But back in Redlands and back in the old hometown. And my best story is when he brought Larry's truck to go down the Imperial Valley to pick up lettuce. We picked up several lettuce one day. And I didn't know anything about trucking. Terry taught me everything I know, which isn't much, but it's not because he didn't try. So he's been my friend for all those years, and I love him. I've loved him since the 70s, and here we are today in the 21st century. So thanks, Terry, for all you've done. Thanks for the boys, and we love you guys.
Mexico, on I-40, like a Texas lizard on glass. 1,000 pedals was mashing the metal, and bears was a-walking the grass. We trucked all day, and we trucked all night, Big Benny improving our style. We could tell by the smell we was heading for hell, and the devil was Dirty Lyle.
I guess I'm supposed to say something nice about Terry. That's the hard part of this. But I think the first time I met Terry was on down at Ontario, and I do not remember what year that was.
Was it the convention?
Yeah.
89.
That was a long time ago. And then we just got along. He was very helpful to everybody like he is, and it all worked out. And then next time, I think we'd gone to, Colorado, and you know, each time I got to know him better and better, and then I got involved with that Hayes Truck Museum. Terry was chairman, I think, at the time, and so we had some pretty good meetings and some pretty not so good meetings. Anyway, it was always good, and I always enjoyed Terry a lot, and I hope that his health is okay and everything's going along good. And here at this show, I have not seen him yet, but I'm going to make an effort to go see him. Terry's just a great guy and a great asset to this whole group here. So I do hope everything goes good for he and Ellie.
Okay. All right. First time I met Terry was at the Dunnigan Truck Stop, where they call it Pantyhose Junction in the old days. And my son was with my son Kenny. We were going to, I think it was Yakima, it was before that, way before that. And so I introduced Kenny. I said, "This is Mr. Dalton." And Terry's face dropped about 2 feet. And he says, and he started cussing, raising heck. He says, "My name's not Dalton." And I was really embarrassed about that. But the main thing with Terry is I've had two mentors in the trucking business. One is Terry Fortier in Fresno. The other one is Terry Kalinske. Every time we go to a truck show, it's like a seminar in college of how to run a truck company in this screwed up industry we're in. And I always learned, and always when I spotted Terry, that's where I went and that's where I hung out. to try to learn something from the man. And apparently I didn't learn enough. And I can't say anything. I love the guy. And that's all I'm going to say.
I got a couple of memories.
That's perfect.
One is when he came up to my house for my pick and barbecue. And he sat out there, and it overlooks the valley, and he sat there and he enjoyed himself so much. And I realized this is why we're here. Guys like him, you know, he just brought, I don't know, just a feel over the whole group. And he just talked about how much the group was important to him. Another one is I bought that Trumbleville trailer and I didn't know anything about why it had doors up top, you know. So he explained the whole hauling lettuce deal, yep, and how you put the ice on top. And so, but I mean, I've been trucking with him for 20 some years, and if he's not at a show, it's disappointing, to say the least, especially Brooks.
Yeah.
So.
Thank you,
Terry. Here's to you, Terry.
The first time we went to a truck show that I did, we went to Yakima, yeah, and I did the first stint with Terry in his truck, and all we did was talk about America and the country and the trucks. It was fantastic, so informative, but such a good time with Terry. It was wonderful. Yeah, he's in life.
He's in life.
Yeah. Yeah. Happy go lucky.
We all remember his life.
Yeah, he made the trip.
Plenty of good trips with Terry. Been a bit of an inspiration to all of us. Oh, sorry, got a sore throat. But yeah, he probably got me really going into the truck show scene in Sydney. We didn't have much of a truck show there until we met Terry and saw what the ATHS did here. And now we've basically got the biggest truck show in the Southern Hemisphere now, thanks to Terry and his inspiration. He's well thought of down under. And yeah, he was one of the driving forces for us to come over here. And we're living our dream driving Terry's trucks. So I couldn't hope for anything more unbelievable. Thanks, Terry.
Yeah, well, my first opportunity was obviously Yakima, and I
met a few get coming over here and working out who was going to drive which truck. And I was pretty bold, and I said, yeah, I'm happy to drive the twin sticker along with John here. And so we decided to share that up to Yakima. And
It was up to the driving test.
Yeah, it was, yeah. So Josh took us for a driving test after saying who he's driving the truck, and John and I put our hands up, and he said to me, how much experience have you had? And I said, oh, I drove a B-model back once for about 15 minutes. And he just went like this, and he goes, what about you? And John said, nah, never driven one, mate. So we went out for the driving test, and John puckered his finger up a fair bit there, as I did when we got behind the wheel there. But no, we managed to get it up there and back, and to be asked to come and do it again was an honour. But I mean, we owe it to Chapo really for introducing us to Terry, and now, you know, being able to have these boys here will come along who haven't been before for all of us. It's just the most memorable experience. Terry, no, it's just a great made us, made our lives work out.
Well, you can see what Terry's done as well. Number of walk around inside us pushing the point of the truck shows in Sydney now, and every second person inside's either a Aussie or a Kiwi. And you know, like, and that's probably due to Terry, and Bruce really pumps it on our Facebook pages what we're doing. And you know, like, we can't thank him enough. You know, like, yeah. Bruce with his twin stick changing going to Yakima and coming up here as well.
Yeah, it's every second person I spoke to last night at the table we were sitting, and they asked how we came here and what we're doing. Oh, you really came from Australia that far? And we told them about the trucks and Josh and Terry, and they were and everyone knew Terry.
Yeah.
Everyone. And holds him in really high regard. Well, so that's a feather in Terry's cap.
Just sitting at the tables, and of course we know Terry, like all past presidents come around and say hello to us, and the table we were sitting on in Salem, was just two of us sitting there and a whole heap of Americans, and we had so many past presidents come around to say hello to us, and the people on the table said, man, we have never even met one president, let alone five old presidents, and that's all due to Terry, you know. And we pushed that out because, you know, we're a little bit outgoing Aussies.
Really?
Yeah, we are a little bit. And yeah, just drag everybody into what, you know, when we're having fun, it doesn't matter if it's in the banquet or having a drink down at the bar, or, you know. And I think Josh has even seen what we're like. He was probably a little bit sceptical of us when we first got here, but I think he's even partial Aussie now.
Yeah, you can come over any time, Josh. Yeah.
Well, again.
Yeah. And I do think, just another thing, we're all about pushing the younger generation, as we do at home as well. And it's something that's been always a problem with you, with having you guys getting involved. So when Victor came over here, I think great to be Tyler's mom. He's 13, he'd come along with his first time.
That's great.
I drove the trucks better.
No,
my first trip over here too, I was lucky enough to have a father who brought me over when I was 10 years old in the 80s, and the boys said to me, Dave, come over, you'll really enjoy it. But I really can't believe the generosity and how well known. I said I'd come up with the Dalton trucks up to the show, and every person I spoke to in there knows the company and knows you guys and how many trucks you put on. So for me, it's just an absolute pleasure and an honour to be here, and I've just had an absolute ball with the guys. So thanks, Terry. D2 out.
Anyway, Mr. Terry Klinsky, you cannot find a better gentleman. He helped me the last 5 years with putting on truck shows, with the best advice that anybody could offer to get you through it and make everything right. He always had the right answer to the wrong question. Always. Always had that. And I cherish him until the day I'm no longer around. And I'm proud to say that he's my friend, and I hope he feels the same way.
Terry,
just want to say how much I appreciate being able to work for you all these years and providing for my family and all my kids. And your brother told me to come work for you years before I happened to even come down there and go to work. It was when I still had my own truck, and I should have done it sooner, apparently. But anyway, honor to be, you know, working for you. Thank you.
A 5-minute story.
Well, I can't thank him enough for letting me bring my truck and tagging along and everything that goes with it. I'm very humbled by it, you know.
You can't drive.
Yeah. He's always been good to me, him and Ellie both, and I appreciate everything that he's done and is doing. And I feel proud and honored that he asked me to participate.
Terry does a lot for me, and I do stuff for him. You know, the first time we went to Missouri, it was a lot of fun, and I just enjoy Terry and Elliot a lot.
So my name's Josh Klinsky. You've heard or gonna hear a bunch of stuff about my dad and antique trucks and what he's meant for the trucking industry and his friends in it and all that. And this is the ATHS convention in Reno 2019. And this is where really a lot of the truckers and the, you know, a lot of the old time truckers show up and they meet their friends, you know, they meet new friends, and it's really a great time to get together and enjoy the best part of trucking. You know, there's no ELDs, there's no log books. We just go trucking down the road. You gotta have a medical card still, but you enjoy it. There's stories, funny things happen. You lose sets of duels off of trucks. You know, as you're pulling in the show, that could have killed somebody out on the highway, but the Lord's with us in grace. You know, and stuff like that happens all the time, but that's just life. So, you know, it makes stories and stuff. But the story for this part is, this is the auto car. It's a 1948. This is where antique trucks really began with my dad. And, you know, he had old trucks in the past. You know, he started in, 60 or something with his first truck, which we've got a copy of here. But this is our first real antique. We bought this truck in 1979, and it was, you know, supposedly my brother's truck. You know, he was 79, he would have been 12 or 11, born in 69, so 10. And I was about 8, and Matt was 10 then. And this was our goat cart growing up as kids. You know, we'd fire it up. It's got what's called a double disc pump in it, which is an old style pump before the PT pumps came out at Cummins. And so it's mechanical. But if this thing sucks air, the RPM runs away. You can't shut it off. You can't even, if you really get sucking air bad, you can't even pull the compression release to kill it. So as little kids, you know, we learned to check the fuel, and we'd fire it up and grab first gear and, you know, get it in a second, run it back and forth, run direct over in the brownie and all that kind of stuff. And it was our go-kart. When other kids had go-karts, we had trucks. And we made dust with them. Of course, we had the go-karts too, but I'll fire this thing up and wrap it out. So it's got a non-turbocharged 200 Cummins, which is 743 cubic inch. No muffler, no turbo. It's naturally aspirated. So it's got an old-fashioned bark to it that modern trucks just don't duplicate. And you got to crank them a while, too, before you start them up.